So the Pentagon gets the green light to spend valuable defense funds on things like efforts to make biofuels. The military's focus on alternative energy sources has faced constant debate in Congress this year, and I think rightly so. Republican Senator James Inhofe is a member of the Armed Services Committee. And Senator, welcome back to the show. And when I go through these stats, it is really staggering. I mean, you look at the Air Force, which paid $59 a gallon for 11,000 gallons of alternative fuel. The Navy spent $12 million on biofuels at a rate of $26 a gallon. At a time when we're talking about raising taxes and the fiscal cliff and what financial problems we are in this country, when I read these numbers, I want to tear my hair out. How do you feel?
Well, Melissa, it's worse than that. In 2009, he had the Navy pay $424 a gallon for 20,000 gallons. Now, that's fuel that on the market that you could buy for $3 a gallon. $424 a gallon. Now, I think to really understand, you have to keep in mind, this president has had a war on our defense system. He's disarmed America. He's done away with our brigade combat teams, our ships, our F-22s, our C-17s, our future combat system. And then he'll use the excuse, no, I have not reduced the budget for the defense. But what he's done, Melissa, is move his green agenda into the under the defense so that we're paying for all this. Now, Senator McCain and I took this out. We had two changes that we made in the law to keep them from doing that. One was a section that said you can no longer use our readiness dollars to buy all this fuel and all this stuff. And then we also had a prohibition against using defense dollars to build refineries. That can be done in the private sector. Well, on the floor, there was an amendment. It's pretty much down party lines. Mark Udall had one amendment, and Hagan had the other one, to kill our efforts to keep them from using our defense dollars for a green agenda.
Does anybody at the White House understand that when people are upset about having their taxes raised, because I know there are a lot of people out there that want to raise other people's taxes, but when you get upset about having your own taxes raised, it's because we see ridiculous spending like this going on. And you say, if you can't spend my tax dollars responsibly for things that make sense, I don't want to send you anymore. I mean, does anyone get that sentiment?
No, they don't get that sentiment, Melissa. That's the problem. Now, the excuse they use for this is kind of interesting. They say that this is going to wean us off of Middle Eastern oil. Somehow we won't be using petroleum-based fuels. Well, that is not true at all. If you want to get off of Middle Eastern oil, all he'd have to do is open up the United States so that we can exploit our own we're the only country in the world that doesn't exploit our own resources. And we have more recoverable reserves in coal, oil, and gas in America than any other country has.
Do you think
we could actually be totally independent in a matter of weeks?
Is there any chance to stop this, do you think? I mean, I know you're going out, one of the moves is to go out and try and tell people about this so that they understand that we're spending $59 a gallon on fuel, money that we don't have. But is there any way to really stop it in its tracks? Because this kind of spending makes me really want to tear my hair out.
Well, it should make you want to tear your hair out. Way back in 2009, the first big bunch was, that's where he came up with the $424 a gallon. We said it, we talked about it, and there's a lot of interest. I can tell you, my people in my state of Oklahoma, they're outraged, but somehow this just doesn't seem to get out. And we have other things. I mean, let's remember, when Republicans were a majority in the House and the Senate, and we had Clinton, who was a Democrat, we put work requirements in welfare. We cut the number of people on welfare down from about 5 million to 3 million.
Okay.
Then Obama comes in, and so he reinstates it and takes the work requirements out. And now people are outraged
stop this one next, because this one is absolutely insane. Thank you so much for coming on tonight. We appreciate your time. All right.
You bet.
Time now for today's Fuel Gauge report.